Good morning, everybody. How are you today? Yeah. Come on, good morning. How are you today? Yeah. All right. So far, we've been having fun at King's Court. We've been learning that God is different than us, right? Yeah. He's invisible. Do you remember I shot someone in the face with an air zuka? Do you remember that? So just because you can't see air doesn't mean air doesn't exist, right? Just because you can't see God doesn't mean God doesn't exist. Here's the thing. Someone taught this to me once. Just because I can't see God doesn't mean that God can't see me. He always sees me. And last week, remember we played with those windmills? And did we know how to do it?
No,
right, because you needed special directions in order to do it. Because if you don't follow directions, it's not going to work. And that's like so much in life. There's so many things we can't do unless we follow directions. And sometimes when we don't follow directions, there are consequences. Consequences. I have something here that, does anyone know what a consequence is? What's a consequence? What's a good definition of a consequence? Ooh, a punishment, yeah. I know none of us likes punishment, but sometimes there are consequences. So I brought this thing in here that, you know what this is? Nobody knows what this is. Anybody know what it is? What is it? A bear trap. Yeah, well, this is probably a little smaller than a bear trap. I don't think a bear could fit in this one, but this is probably for a smaller type of animal. And this is a raccoon, sure, I bet that could fall into it. And I also use it for children that don't pay attention. And parents that don't pay attention. Summer. Hi. All right, so the way this works is big and nasty. It's got springs and coils and and so what I'm going to do is I'm going to open it up, and it opens up, and put this lever down, and
some people... Don't hurry.
I don't want to hurt myself. I'm going to hurt a kid. No, I'm not going to hurt a kid. And the way the trap works is who would put their hand or foot or paw in a trap on purpose? Nobody! Nobody! The reason why it's effective is because it's hidden. Now, you and I, we're humans, we're not going to fall for that. But to an animal, right? Oh boy, maybe they put some food on there, right on that little spot right there. Oh, it smells good. Everybody do the smelling. Oh, it smells good, right? Oh, I want to go near that thing. And maybe they put some leaves over it so they can't quite see it. And what makes a trap work is that you don't know that it's going to trap you. If there was a big sign that said in bear language, that's bear language for, hey, don't put your paw in there, okay? Then the bear wouldn't put their paw in there. The only reason why a trap works is because you don't know that it's going to hurt you. And that's what makes traps so dangerous. If things that hurt us, if we knew they were going to hurt us, it wouldn't be dangerous. We'd stay away from them. Right? You see a big hot stove, you're not going to touch it because you know that's going to hurt you. You see a car coming. You're not going to walk in front of it because you know it's going to hurt you. But there are traps in life, guys, that look pretty good. And that's where sin comes in. Sin is saying, I like that. I don't think it's going to hurt me. You know, I like lying to my mom and dad because I got away with it last time. That's fun. I like getting extra video game time when I'm not supposed to because that's fun. And I don't think it's going to hurt me. How can that hurt me? But that's the lie. See, sin always hurts. Sin is when you break God's law, when you do something that is against what he says. This is what the Bible says. In Romans 6:23, I bet a lot of you have memorized this verse. It says, for the wages of sin is death. That's right, the wages of sin is death. Now, that's a verse that we memorize all the time. And sometimes when you memorize a verse a lot, it's good because it gets in our heart. But sometimes it's bad because you're like, oh yeah, the wage of sin is death. I've heard that a million times. But think about that. Does anybody know what a wage is? What's a wage? Yeah. Money. It's something you earn. So if I give you money for Christmas, is that a wage? No. I gave it to you as a gift. You didn't earn it. I just gave it to you as a gift. By the way, don't come to me for money. I'm not giving anything as money. So, but that's a gift. But wage is what you earn. So your parents, when they go to work and they toil and they work hard, at the end of the week, their employer says, here's your money. You earned this. This is what you earned. Maybe you guys do some chores around the house. You might get some money for that. You earned it. So what the Word of God is saying, we earn death. We earn our punishment. We earn hell because of our sin. And we've all done it. And we earned it. Like, it's what we deserve. We deserve hell. And what happens is our sin is like a trap. So what I want someone to do is I want someone to come along. She wants, come on up. Oh, thank you. What's your name? Elizabeth. Beautiful name. Take this, hold it by the top, not by the side, by the top, and hold it with this hand. And I want you to set it down. Okay. Here you go. Push down a little bit. What do you think of that, Elizabeth? Did that scare you? Just a little bit? Yeah. Hey, you're all right, right?
Okay. Okay.
Why don't you get it on this? Can you get it out? Can you pull it out? Can you pull it out? Hey, but who wants to pull on it? Hey, pull on it. Pull on it, pull on it. Everybody pull. Hey. Whoa! Okay, stop. Look at this. Look at this. Like, look at this. 20 munchkins couldn't get this out. Because I want you to remember this. The trap doesn't look dangerous to us. But once it ensnares you, you're stuck. And that's what sin does. How many sins did Adam and Eve do before they got kicked out of the Garden of Eden? How many? Just one. How many sins have we done? Yeah. Sin is constantly, we can't pull ourselves out of our sin. Once we do it, boom, we're trapped. The wages of sin is death. Anybody know what this is? Rubik's Cube. How annoying is a Rubik's Cube that is undone? I think a Rubik's Cube that is undone is sort of like sin. Because it's wrong, it's bad, it's not the way it's supposed to be, and we tear it and go, oh, I'm going to try to make it better, but we don't make it better, in fact, we make it worse, and we're like, oh, but if I only do this, if I only do that, maybe if I go to church, that'll make my sin problem better, maybe if I listen to my parents more, maybe if I do this, and it doesn't, well, we can turn it all we want, and it doesn't matter, it just gets ruined, because we can't fix our sin problem. But here's the thing, if we give it up to God, God can do what we can't do. See that? God can do what we can't do. He can solve our sin problem. Now, every single one of us has a sin problem, and we need God to solve it. You guys are thinking, if you know the wages of sin is death, the verse continues, but the gift, I love gifts, the gift of God is eternal life. Who here, if you are alive, if you have blood flowing through your veins, you're thinking, how do I get the free gift of eternal life? How do I do it? I want to know. I want my sin from. I want to get out of the trap. I can't get myself out of the trap. Only God can get me out of the trap. What is God's plan for getting me out of the trap? And I'm going to tell you God's plan for getting you out of the trap. Starting next week. So keep coming. That's part of it, but there's a reason why that works. It's not just a formula. It's not just something that we do. There's a reason why. And I'm going to share that with you starting next week. I'm excited. Look, here's the thing. Sin is real. Sin is real. And sin has consequences. And we can't get out of it on our own. We need someone to rescue us. If you were an animal trapped in one of these, you can't get yourself out. You need someone to come and rescue you. Well, how can you be rescued? We're going to talk about how Jesus rescues us. We're going to start it next week. Let me pray for you guys. Lord Jesus, thank you so much for these wonderful children. I thank you that they're thinking, that they understand, that even a child can understand that sin is dangerous. It hurts us. It traps us. And it keeps us forever. And if we do not get rescued, it will take us to the lake of fire. God, thank you that there is a rescuer. And I look forward to next week when we start talking about that rescuer. God, I pray that every child here will think about these things, that they'll think about the wages of sin is death. They can understand this, even at their age, and that they'll look forward to the gift of God, which is eternal life in Jesus Christ, our Lord. God, please bless and help them have a great time to do basketball. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
All right, guys.